各位，我哋到開會嘅時間，亦都
We have reached the time and the quorum. And thank you for coming to the meeting. We will be electing our chair and the vice chair for this committee. And this is the Public Works Subcommittee. And this is the election of the chairman and vice chairman. I would like to know whether you are still the chairman. Yes, yes. I am still the chairman for this part of the meeting because I was the chairman before the session. But may I ask you a question just to clarify the following? Because I see that you have jointly signed for Mr. Liu Cheng Kong in amending the procedures for the Finance Committee. You have signed that letter. And item 5 there says that for the PWSC and the ESC, if we have made the resolution, it does not need to be discussed and passed at the Finance Committee. My question is, this greatly affects the procedures and the workings of the committee. Now, I would like to know why you only publicize that you are a signatory of the letter only after the procedures of these two committees. Well, because this is not on the agenda of today's meeting. Well, I just want you to answer that question before you stand for election as chairman. Can you please explain why you did that? I think Mr. Zhu was wrong. Because at present, there is still no nomination from members as yet. So it is not about you now standing for election or registering or applying to stand for election. Well, first of all, yes, indeed, procedurally, you may not be nominated and you have not applied to stand for election. But on the other hand, whether you have an opponent or not, would you answer the question raised by Mr. Zhu just now, because this will pertain to whether there will be opponents to your nomination or to your standing for election. Now, if there are questions, we can refer to the House Committee and the Finance Committee procedures and provide a short period of time for so doing. But today's meeting, we have a very short time for the meeting only, so perhaps we will not deal with this until we come to that particular part of the meeting. Now, according to Section 6 to 8A of the procedures of the committee, let us now proceed with the nomination. We need one member for verbal nomination and one seconder verbally, and the nominated member will have to accept the nomination. Dr. Kwokaki, I nominate Chu Hoitik. Seconder? Yes, Chen Chi-chun. Do you accept this nomination, Chu Hoitik? Yes. Lo Wai Kwok, I nominate Lo Wai Kwok. Seconder, please. Chan Hakan? Yes, second. I accept this nomination. Now, because I have been nominated and I've accepted the nomination, I will ask the Vice Chairman, Mr. Mok Nai Kwong, to chair this part of the meeting, which is the election part of the meeting. Are there any other nominations apart from the two that we've received so far? I'll count to three. One, two, three. No other nominations. We will now go into the voting. Is that right? If there are no nominations, I announce that there will be a secret ballot, or rather voting for the chairman.
對不起,你宣佈了。
Now, the secretary had checked for me, and on this side of the room, the members have already raised their point. Now, because of the very limited time we have for this meeting, let us allow Mr. Lo Wai Kwok, I think, to ask a question. I think there is only one question to ask a question. We've already raised that query. You said you did not see us? No, I see you. Now, so you are raising a question to Mr. Lo Wai Kwok, but I still have to control the time. Oh yes, calm down. Shall we allow 10 minutes for questions maximum? Can we agree on that? And for each member, I will allow, let's say, 30 seconds to raise a question, and after that, Mr. Lo Wai Kwok will answer the question, and then Mr. Chu Hoi Teck, of course, can also answer the question, and the answer can be longer. All right, okay, I see. Question and answer. 30 seconds for answer as well. So total 10 minutes for this question session. Dr. Kwakaki, procedurally, can you please refer to the Finance Committee election procedures? I think that would be better. The president was 30 minutes, I think. Please don't change that president, please. Now, we have the full council meeting after this, so we have limited time. I will allow 30 minutes for question, 30 seconds for question, 30 seconds for answer, and total 20 minutes for all Q&A. We will begin now, and hopefully we will be able to elect the chairman at this meeting. There is an objection. Chan Hanban, do you want to speak? Well, you announced that we were to vote, and I'm well prepared to vote right now. Fernando Zheng, can you allow 30 minutes? We have plenty of time. The next meeting does not begin until 11 a.m., so I think the Q&A, the query, is important because this is important because in candidate for the chairmanship is saying that he wants to change the rules of the game, and this is very grave indeed. Now, I fear if we allow 30 minutes and then we have to cast our votes and then we have to announce the results, etc., 30 minutes just too long. 20 minutes then. 20 minutes, all right. Ms. McMahon, I will not filibuster. I'm just asking a question. It says 10:30 here. That's the paper document we received. The meeting ends 10:30. You are now the chairman for this part of the meeting, isn't it? Do you have the authority to extend the meeting to after 10:30? Otherwise, how can we have 30 minutes or 20 minutes for discussion? Yes, I have the authority to extend the time of the meeting, and the objective is to complete the election for chairman and vice chairman. because the agenda item is but one for this meeting, and that is for the election of the chairman and the vice chairman. Shall we begin? So do we raise our hand or do we press the button here? Yes, let's see who wants to raise a question by raising the hand. Lam Kin Fong, Kwa Ka Ki, Chen Chi Chun, Wong Ding Guang, Sari Lee. Dr. Ferdinand Chang and Claudia Mo. Lam Kin Fong. Mr. Chairman, in the last session for Public Works Subcommittee, we see members repeating the questions time and again, and the progress was very slow. How do we solve that problem? And now Chu Hoi Tik and then Lo Wai Kwok. Well, actually, to solve this problem, we have said this many times to the government. First of all, the documents will have to include, in the first instance, the entire document and report rather than the excerpts. So that will save a couple of meetings. And secondly, the answers to the questions need to be in earnest. If the government can do this, then I think the committee can be very smooth in its proceedings. Well, actually, you are the person who repeats and repeats the question in most incidents. Now, this is not a dialogue between members, please. Mr. Lo Wai Kwok, can you respond in 30 seconds? Well, the work of the committee has been authorized by the Finance Committee to look at public works projects. The Secretariat has supported us in the past year, and we have recorded the content and the parameters of all the questions raised by members. And yes, we have been alerted to repeated questions. And yes, the government officers coming to the meeting should utilize their answer time well. Dr. Kwok Ka Kee, Mr. Chairman, in the past 1 year, Mr. Lo Wai Kwok, in handling the items, he had been hurrying procedures along to help the government pass controversial items. And he had not been serious in asking the government officers for further information. And does Mr. Lo Wai Kwok have commitments and plans to commit to not passing white elephant projects? Well, I think the government also wants to be able to be efficient. But we have 73 hours of meetings and discussing over 20 projects, but there are still 20 projects outstanding, and this is unduly long discussion time for the projects. And I think members also need to try their best to smoothen the procedure. Chu Hoi Tik, I hope colleagues would not use the term normal or not normal to describe the procedures of the work of the committee. What we want to do is to be effective in monitoring the proposals and work of the government. And we are happy to give this kind of work time if the government is sincere in being interactive with us. Chen Qichun, Liu Chenkwang and also Mr. Lo Wai Kwok included, have raised the proposal that the resolution passed by the committee will have to be passed by at least half of the number of the members before it can be discussed in the Finance Committee. Now, this is contracting the authority of the members of this committee and extending the authority and power of the Finance Committee. Why was this raised after the closure of work of this committee? Chu Hoi Tik, I want Lo Wai Kwok to explain the following, and that is committee members are stripped of their power to participate in the committee's work with due provision of information or full provision of information. Well, I'm surprised why Chu Hoitek is asking another question. But yes, going to the Finance Committee, if there can be a separation for voting, that is acceptable. But if there is a separation for discussion, then I think members will have to agree on that. And that is, there had always been three stages from the committee to the Finance Committee. The proposal was basically just to make the entire process more efficient and effective. Wong Ting Huang. Now, filibustering at the discussions of the PWSC had been a fact. I would like to ask how Mr. Lo Wai Kwok will be able to ascertain that procedures will be efficient. Yes, the procedures will have to be fair and open and efficient. If during the meeting there are repeated and lengthy questions asked and it exceeds what is reasonable for the meeting, then the chair should control the meeting. But of course, this will require support from the members. And of course, we are monitored by the public as well. So our behavior at the meetings, well, we have to be careful about it. Chiu Hai-tik, Mr. Lo Wai Kwok talked about the three phases or three stages. What you are doing now by signing that letter is to delete that third stage. And that is to say, our resolution cannot be discussed at the Finance Committee, but in fact, the committee members can raise questions at the Finance Committee. How can you not clarify or seek our approval before you propose that new procedure? Starry Lee? Well, because of repeated question and which is being used as a tool for filibustering, there had been a lot of cessation of meetings, and also the meetings could not go through time and again. Now, my question to Lo Wai Kwok is, how come there were a lot of projects and items which were not discussed at the PWSC?
Mr. DG, for amendment adjournment motions, well, perhaps pro-establishment members were not present at meetings throughout. I'm quite familiar with matters. Adjournment motions and debates can turn the discussion into a Q&A session, into a scenario where we can express our views, and that will allow a dialogue with officials. Your time is up. Mr. Lo Wai Kwok, when PWSC examined the XRL-related agenda items, we had six meetings, and adjournment motions were raised at each of the six meetings. That's far from desirable. Well, if we considered the matter important, we wanted more time, then we should make good use of each and every meeting, because it was not easy to schedule meetings for PWSA, and we should grasp our time properly. Dr. Fernando Zhou. Thank you, Chairman. Mr. Lo Wai Kwok, you just mentioned the XRL, which has a cost overrun of over $20 billion already. Government projects have seen tens of billions of dollars in a cost overrun, and that is public money and contributed by taxpayers. So government officials beat around the bush and didn't answer our questions directly, causing cost overrun. What is your view on that, Mr. Wai Kwok? According to government statistics, although there were projects that had seen cost overrun, but there were also projects that spent much less than what was budgeted. So, overall speaking, the overall amount was smaller than was approved. Yes, for some items, the extent of cost overrun was not desirable, and we should step up our monitoring. Mr. Adiju, my view is simple. If I were the chairman of PWSC, if there's a cost overrun and if the government cannot provide us with the full copy of a report, then there is no point in convening the meeting. So I will make it very clear to the government that we must have all the papers before we meet. So as the chairman of the PWSC, the chairman should be the gatekeeper. Ms. Claudia Mo, we're here to monitor how the government spends money. I'm still not happy with the Disney project. It was money down the drains. Members said that there should be an appropriate a time for meetings. However, the government decided to jump the queue for the Disney item. And do you think that the government is really anxious for what our people care for? You should be more honest as the chairman. Mr. Adiju, I agree with Ms. Claudia Mo. For the proposed amendments to the rules of meeting of the FC, we really have to be wary of the proposal on whether FC will have the chance to discuss items approved by PWSC. I think Mr. Lo Wai Kwok owes us an explanation. He has to allow members who didn't have the chance to come to PWSC, or allow a chance for FC members who are not PWSC members to ask questions. Strange that Mr. Eddie Ju is asking questions again. Well, even for members who are not members of PWSC, they can come to the FC to ask questions. So if you do care for a certain item, you should be present at the panel or the PWSC meeting. So for all members who care for PWSC items, I think they should have asked to join the subcommittee. Mr. Fen Yue, so Mr. Liu said that we spend 73 hours on 20-odd items on average. We spent 3 hours on one item. I'm baffled. Does Mr. Liu think that even 3 hours are too long? Does he want to shorten it to 1 hour or even half an hour? He said that we should play a better role of monitoring. I don't know what is his standard. He thinks that even 3 hours are too long. So what is your ideal, Mr. Lo? Well, in the last session, among the 20-odd items, some of them, such as sewage projects, were approved very quickly. So on average, we spend more than 4 hours on each item. On average, there are 40 to 50 or even more PWSC projects for us to consider in a year. So in the process, we must stick to our three-step process. For policy matters, they are already discussed in panels. Mr. Low is using the mentality of a factory production. He talks about the number of hours spent on per hour per item that is reasonable, but this is not the attitude of legislature. And when we ask questions, he smeared us for filibustering. This is not the right attitude of PWSC chairman. I hope he will not continue to act like the manager of a factory. Mr. Michael Tian. Members may recall that I objected the funding application for Disneyland. I supported adjournment debate. However, I didn't think that matter should be suspended because it was wrong for us to receive payment from taxpayers and do not go to meetings. I've been asked by members in the community many times since you have adjourned the discussion of certain items, so why should a meeting be suspended? Thank you. Your time is up. Mr. Adiju, why do we have this provision or this choice of adjournment for members? Because I hope Members understand that for all adjournment motions and debates, they play unique roles in different scenarios. The purpose is to ensure that the administration will spend the time after meeting is adjourned to review the whole item. Mr. Lo Wai Kwok, at one PWSC meeting, we had 8 extra hours on a Saturday, and then after lunch, a member asked for adjournment successfully, so we could only spend 4 hours in the morning for an extra PWSC meeting. I believe all members of the public would feel extremely disappointed. It was not easy to schedule a meeting. We should not use an adjournment motion to waste time. It would make us difficult to be accountable to the public. This meeting was scheduled to end by 10:30, which is 5 minutes from here. We won't have enough time to complete this procedure. I'd like to ask whether members agree that we extend the meeting until we have elected the chairman or even the vice chairman for the subcommittee. Any objection, please? Then we should vote now. Please make yourself clear. I don't know what is your position. So you are for extending the meeting. So he's the only one here? Mr. Yu Siwing, is it on a similar point? Chairman, I'd like to know how long do you want a meeting to be extended, to be exact, so that we can have an idea. So is it that after the extension, we can at least elect the chairman, because I don't want that the meeting to be abortive. So please tell us when we're going to vote. I don't have any other members on the list waiting to ask questions. So I think after our time extension, at least we will have, at most, we have 1 or 2 members. And that will use up my 20 minutes already. So if there are no further questions from members, we can proceed to a vote at once. Ms. Andrew Wen, so will be the last 30 seconds. So I didn't quite get Mr. Lo Wai Kwok's answer. He said 73 hours were spent on 20 odd items. I fail to understand how is 4 odd hours per item. Roughly speaking, we spent about 150 minutes on per item. So 3 minutes each, only 50 members were asked questions, not even the whole council. So I don't quite understand what he meant. Mr. Low, there were quite a number of items discussed together jointly. So in the earlier part of the last session, on average, we spent 4 to 5 hours before one item could be passed. And then we've almost doubled. We have more than doubled our scheduled meeting time. So the progress was indeed relatively slow. Mr. Eddie Ju, when it comes to the effectiveness of the meeting, I strongly suggest that pandems and also pro-establishment members jointly ask the government to be more responsible and to give us a more comprehensive information. This is the most effective way, and I really don't want the last of the 3-step process to be scrapped. Your time is up, Mr. Zhu. All right, since there are no other nominations, I declare that we proceed to a secret ballot. Can secretariat staff please distribute the ballot papers and also a chop? After you have all voted, I will declare the voting closed and no more ballot papers will be handed out. Then the ballot papers will be collected. you have to put the ballot paper into the ballot box personally. Before you've done so, please do not leave your seat. And each candidate has been assigned a number, and Mr. Eddie Chu is number one, Mr. Loh Wai Kwok number two. Please fix the seal on the candidate you prefer, and please do not show your ballot paper to another person. There is no need to fold the ballot paper after you've voted. Have we all got a ballot paper, please?
咁如果
Now, if you filled out the ballot paper, and if you have all completed filling out the ballot paper, we announce the closure of the balloting process here. How many ballot papers have we distributed? 48. 48. Yes, the staff will now collect the ballot papers from you. I invite the two members, Dr. Kwok Kah Kee and Mr. Lau Yip Kang, to be the scrutineers for the vote counting.
One.
1 1 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 1 1 Do we have the total votes? 48? Yes, we have distributed 48 ballot papers and we have 48 votes. This is the result of the voting. Chu Hoi-tik, number 1, has 16 votes and Lo Wai Kwok has 32 votes. Mr. Lo Wai Kwok is the chair of the Public Works Subcommittee for this session. And would he please chair the latter part of this meeting, please? Thank you for your support, colleagues. In this year, we will be working closely together. The vice chairman election follows. Do you have a question, Mr. Lam? Chair, a procedural question for your consideration, please. When we were counting the votes just now, were the votes not mixed? Well, all the votes or ballot papers were put or poured into a big box from the small boxes. Well, I think we need to mix them up after the ballots have been put into the big box. If you look at the order of the votes, it becomes no longer a secret ballot. I hope the Secretariat can pay attention to this because this will set a precedent for the future. All right, 2017-2018 Public Works Subcommittee Vice Chairman election, one nomination verbal from a member and one seconder from a member expressed verbally. Ms. Chen, thank you. I propose or nominate Charles Mok. Mr. Wen Zhugun seconds the nomination. Mr. Mok, do you accept the nomination? Yes, I do. Other nominations, please. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. No other nominations. I announce that Mr. Charles Mok is elected as vice chair ipso facto. As for the next meeting, it will be on the 18th of October 2017, which is a Wednesday, 8:30 a.m. As for the timetable for the rest of the year, the Secretariat will provide the same after the meeting, and we can discuss the schedule of meetings for this year. I announce this meeting closed. Thank you very much for coming.